As far as
TV West,
which is a failing pile of garbage,
TV West
is terrible.
West is
terrible.
West is
fake news.
West,
it's a disgrace.
One of our very own here at West, Felix Ortiz, was credited for saving the life of a man who had just been in a major car accident. His efforts got the attention of many local news outlets, and today we have this story for you, as told by KSL TV News.
Ugly crash with a driver in desperate need of medical help.
But before first responders could get there, an unlikely rescuer arrived on scene to try and make a difference. News specialist Andrew Adams talked to that man, and he is in the newsroom with that story tonight. Andrew?
Well, that rescuer is a junior at West High School. He says he took a CPR class, learned about it a couple times beyond that, but never expected to be pressed into duty when somebody needed it most.
In the middle of a busy commute, the real chaos was just above the freeway.
So I was just on my way home from school. School just got out. And in the corner of my eye, I see like a car that's flipped over.
An apparent medical problem had caused a driver to crash near an on-ramp.
And I'm like, there's no way this is happening, you know?
At these crossroads of life and death, the sounds of the afternoon drive suddenly were put on mute. Time seemed to slow down. These were critical seconds.
I honestly just decided to jump into action because I saw everyone just standing around. So
high school student Felix Ortiz didn't waste a moment to think about it.
I see the man unconscious in the driver's side. So I run over to the other side, pry open the door because it wasn't going at all. I drag out his legs first because they were stuck in there. I was able to grab him by the belt and just drag him out of the car.
What happened next was a lesson his hands learned in CPR.
I saw that he was pretty purple and he had some foam coming out of his mouth, so I realized he wasn't breathing, and I checked for a pulse, and there was nothing. And I decided I was going to have to be in doing chest compressions on him. And I was getting kind of nervous that I wasn't going to be able to, you know, bring him back. And after about like a minute or so, he started coughing, and I felt super relieved.
Ortiz's hands may have saved a human life.
One of his siblings, I believe, through Facebook, they messaged me saying that I saved his life, and he's in the hospital right now. I believe he's stabilizing now. It's like a relief off your chest that knowing that you saved someone's life. It's crazy because everyone wants to go home at night.
On a drive home that proved to be a first,
I feel like I kind of just did what needed to be done.
Fast action kept this commute from becoming another driver's last.
My parents always come home every day, you know, and it's just crazy knowing that like I was able to help someone see their family member one more time.
Well, tonight, Utah Highway Patrol says the driver is in surgery to fix a heart problem. Apparently, he didn't suffer any injuries from the crash at all. We're told the prognosis pending surgery is good. In the newsroom, Andrew Adams, KSL 5 News.
Very cool. Thank you, Felix, for making us all proud. West High Theater Department is preparing for its spring show, Harvey. We went to interview the director of the play and theater teacher, Stacy Hutchings, about the upcoming show.
Harvey is about a family who is going through some turmoil because the uncle believes that his best friend is a puka, a 6 foot, 1.5 inch white rabbit. Harvey is a contemporary comedy, and so I wanted to do something that was more modern and something lighter than what I did last year. And Harvey has some pretty fun characters. First of all, I would encourage you to come see Harvey because it is your school play and you should be supporting everything in your school. Second, I would recommend you come see Harvey because it's a really funny show. And third, I would recommend that you come see Harvey because a lot of people have put a lot of time and have some really talented artists. Anyone who wants to know any information about Harvey can come see me in room 416. Or you can email me at stacy.hutchings@slcschools.org.
Have you seen a 6-foot-tall rabbit around here at West High?
A 6-foot-tall rabbit here at West High? Not sure. You're gonna have to come see the show.
Performances for Harvey are March 7th through the 9th at 7 p.m. with a matinee at 1 o'clock on the 9th. Tickets cost only $5 at the door or at myschoolfees.com. We hope to see you there. West High's QSA is going strong and is open to everyone, gay, straight, trans, questioning, anyone. Just show up Thursdays after school and prepare for a fun time.
The QSA, or the Queer Straight Alliance, is a place where you can go to be surrounded by people who can be very open-minded and to give you a place where you can go that is just filled with gender and sexuality diversity.
Up next is a segment highlighting Black History Month at West High.
Hi, everyone. Happy Black History Month. As you know, February is Black History Month, and here at Gear Up, we have the student-led project where, the students were not able to be here today because they got sick and one of them just disappeared on me. But so a student of ours drew this beautiful drawing, and thanks to Mr. Smith, who donated this dark brown paper to us. We're rolling these paper to get hair texture, and the reason why we use these colors are because these are Pan-African flag colors, so that we're inclusive to all everyone who identifies as Black or African. And students had different ideas in mind, so we just combined all the ideas together and then ended up removing anything that we thought was not necessary. So we all like had certain ideas, we put all the ideas together, and we had to work together. And these are pictures of all, like, a lot of Black communities throughout the history who made difference in our country.
Next, we travel to the Tech Wing to learn about the Robotics Club. Remember, if you want to join the Robotics Club, talk to Patrick Doty in room T123. The final home game of the season for boys basketball happened last Tuesday. The Panthers played the East Leopards and ended up losing a close one, 48-46. Here are the highlights.
Y'all ain't know why, right?
Love that on that beat.
Let's go!
No masterpiece. Hey. 10 bad bads and they after me.
Bam.
One bad bad look like a masterpiece. Looking for a dunk like an athlete. Big drip, what you call it?
Big drip.
Ice chain, peeled water.
Ice.
You got the cab, but can't afford them.
Cash.
You got the bad, but can't afford them.
Give me the beat, I ride it like a jet ski.
Hey.
So many bad, bad, they harassing me.
Bad.
They like me cause I rap and be with the athletes.
Athletes.
Stop asking me. I know they mad at me.
Nah.
Hop in the coupe, then I slide like it's Vaseline.
Excuse
West Coast 6, four jump like a trampoline.
Six,
take a brick out, put it on the triple beam.
Brick
I'm not from Canada, but I see a lot of teams.
Canada.
Dismantle her, I know how to handle her.
Hey.
Light the candle up, make you put a banner up. Toss
up.
A 50 up, make them tie the club
tie
up.
The club
took
up.
Your bitch out the game, I had to sub her.
Swap, swap.
No masterpiece.
Hey.
10 bad babs and they after me.
Bam.
One bad bad look like a masterpiece. Looking for a dunk like an athlete. Big drip, what you call it?
Big drip, big drip.
Ice chain, peeled water.
Ice.
You got the cab, but can't afford
her.
Cash.
You got the bad, but can't afford
it.
Pippin ain't easy, make her open up and eat it. Stars in the ceiling, in my seats, they tip a peedy. I see them up with watching and they plotting, trying to sneak me.
Yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah.
Good night.
Have you ever wondered how the morning announcements happen every morning? We sent someone to find out.
The morning announcements are quite simple. Students read off of either a piece of paper or their phones and speak into a microphone connected to the PA system. Done, they go back to class. If you would like to see the full morning announcement script, visit the West High website and click on the link that says Morning Announcements under News and Announcements.
Unfortunately, you can't find the joke of the day along with these scripts.
Glad we got that out of the way. Here's a segment about the most unusual clubs at West High.
Hey West High, today we're going to be looking at some of the school's most unusual clubs.
So, to begin, our club journey started with Squash Club freshman year.
Sure.
That's been an officially chartered club at West High School for four years
we're
now.
We're actually having our senior night coming up.
Yeah.
But I'd say the clubs we're most proud of are... This year we started with the Breakfast Club, and then we have the president right here, and then we have the Breakfast Club by yours truly.
We decided to have a club that's a little more inclusive, so
yeah,
if you...
Yeah, mix it up a bit.
So it's Breakfast with the Breakfast Club with the Breakfast Club, and so that's kind of like a meeting for both of
them. Yeah, we actually just had the Breakfast with the Breakfast Club with the Breakfast Club pictures.
In the yearbook. It was great. We had all the members out. We also had Soup Club, Suits Club, Soup and Suits Club, and that was fun.
Pickleball Club, we had Lettuce Club. You want to do the demonstration for that?
Sure. So, because our producer didn't get us lettuce, pretty much the premise of Lettuce Club is whoever can eat a head of lettuce the quickest
is the
becomes
president
the president of
Lettuce
Club.
So we don't have a head of lettuce, but we do have a disgusting peanut butter jelly sandwich.
Well, you know, I made it.
Can I get the tissues?
2,000 years later.
All right, just chuck them on. Thank you, great throw. All right, ready? All right, Lettuce Club starting in 3, 2, 1. Awesome. So in this case, I would be the new Lettuce Club president because I was able to finish the metaphorical lettuce first. But you know, it's a really interesting club because you know, it's like, should you soak the lettuce in water so it's easier to eat? Like, do you chomp down on the lettuce? Is it easier to swallow it whole? So that's actually one of our most strategic clubs. But yeah, no, it's been a really fun journey.
Club.
Thanks for watching, West. Make sure to check out our other episodes on our YouTube channel, and stay frosty.